Oh, I remember now. Okay. I don't know why we are in where we're at, but... No, I don't want to move the whole thing. Just give me... just this one. Yeah.
Not all the animals are friendly, particularly the cranky old bears. But even they can be avoided.
Wait. Bear, like regular bears? There's only one regular bear in the...
Look at the sky.
I need to get away from that. Oh god, my brain.
If I were the Avatar,
I've already started.
About the Fire Nation by now.
If you were the Avatar, I'd surrender to the Fire Nation now.
You know, bite me. Okay, so I guess we have to go immediately help the people who are ambushed or something. I think is what we're doing. What regular wolves are these? I don't know if I want to turn this up or down in my ears. Keep going, Sokka. Sokka, you're on fire again. What is it with Sokka and being on fire? Oh god, I don't even remember how to fight. They're wolves! Why would you assume that? Can I not get that? Is it gone now? Like, is that... I guess it's just gone. Can I just play the whole game as Sokka? I'd like to just play the whole game as Sokka. I mean, I could. But it doesn't... like, it's the Avatar game. I shouldn't just play as the kid with the boomerang the whole time. Even though he is significantly overpowered. Is Katara's whole thing that she only heals? I feel like that undercuts her entire character. Sokka, why are you always on fire? I will never understand. Alright, well, one of them ran off. I didn't do much. I'm gonna be honest with you. Thanks, Katara. Just keep hitting them. Just take out somebody. Thank you, Katara. Alright, I feel like I gotta turn this down in my ear just a little. There we go. You'll be fine, Sokka. What is with this blue tree? It's really interesting. Okay, I think I figured this out. I think Aang's supposed to be the tank. Sokka's the glass cannon. Katara's the healer? Do we meet Toph at any point? This is post Northern Water Tribe. Well, I'm glad at least Katara can heal always injured Sokka. I don't even know if I'm 100% going the correct direction or not. Is Sokka, like, wearing a thing that, like, sets him on fire or something? I don't... like, he's always making the noise, but I don't think it's hurting him. Can I level up yet? I want to start killing these things in less hits. Yeah, no, this... ooh. Oh, man. I still don't... okay. It's fine. It's fine. If this wasn't an Avatar The Last Airbender game, right, I would be having fun with this. Because this is a fun game in its own right. It is just, like, everything else kills me. Like, all the world building kills me, followed up Ooh. Did I get slowed? Is there only one guy? Am I not? What is happening that I'm not at all getting damage? 16 machines remaining. Jesus. Okay. Just a little bit. Figuring out the audio balancing for this is just a nightmare. I think my biggest two complaints is this all has nothing to do with Avatar The Last Airbender at all. And the hitboxes on everything are weird. If I were to boil down... Oh, okay, there's more than just one guy. That didn't do anything. I think I've come into being glitched. Because I'm not getting injured, but I don't... I mean, if I go through the whole game broken like this, I guess I don't care. Please, just give up already. Is that supposed to be Haru? Or Haru's dad, I guess? Kind of looks like him. Kind of sounds like him, too. Love how none of that counted. Hey, I'll take, yes. Thank you for increasing my air blasting. Group rejuvenation. Enrage? Is that why he ends up on fire? Does this mean Sokka's gonna end up on fire more?
There's more over here.
Yeah, that's gotta be him. That's gotta be the guy that voiced Haru's dad.
You deserve that.
Help us out. They just keep coming.
Yeah, that's what it sounds like. But Haru was in book one. I mean, we see him again later, but he's not, you know, helpless. Katara makes a whole point of making them no longer helpless. What if it doesn't actually harm allies? Oh, he isn't on fire. That's him enraged. Oh, okay. That makes way a lot more sense, kind of.
This way.
Unagi boots? Did I just read that right? I love how these guys aren't doing anything to these robots. It looks like only my special attacks are doing damage to these things. No, maybe it's just their hit timing is weird. I don't understand these things. Yeah, well, it's sitting there spun out. It can't get hit. That makes sense.
Over here.
All right.
Thank you for your help.
We meet again. And again, you've helped us fight off the enemy. Yeah, that is... Haru and his dad. The machines attacked without warning. There were too many. Why did they attack? I'm not sure, but they captured Yon. What?
Let's keep moving.
I feel like that should be the... I feel like that should be the name of an airbender. You know what? Our youngest and most talented earthbender. A waterbender was also taken. That can't be a coincidence. We must find out where the machines come from and why they've attacked us. Well, yeah, that machinist or whatever was involved, right? How can we help? Go back to the village and tell the elder about the attack. In the meantime, I'll try to find out more. No problem. Haru will go with you. Yon was one of Haru's close friends. You may need his help. I'll find you when I have more information. Okay, come on, Haru. I've never heard of this dude. Like, Haru, I know, but Yon, no clue. So Haru joined the party. Is he supposed to be the earthbender that we would need and we're not getting Toph ever?
He was my friend.
I don't... Is that actually...
machines show up, a bender disappears.
Oh, Sokka, buddy, you phoned that one in, didn't you? Oh, boy. I don't think that is Haru's voice actor. I have to rewatch that episode. At the very least. Maybe I'll rewatch the one where he's older instead, because I don't know if my heart could take going through that right now.
Are you warmed up yet?
Who, the wolf? I don't understand why they didn't just ask the people what would have been a more convincing thing for us to fight. Well, the only thing we don't have, I guess, is firebending, but since Sokka catches himself on fire a lot, I guess that counts. Yeah, come on. There you go. I got another boot. Badger boots. I swear this game. Yeah, now this game is impossibly easy now that we have Katara. I mean, with Haru, it's a little bit more manageable. Oh, I did finally get hurt. It's just that Katara is keeping us so well topped up that I wasn't even aware.
I thought you guys were good. Are you warmed up yet?
Oh. That's the thing, right? This audio quality, it is not like they got it from a cheap phone call. They had to have somebody in the studio for this. I guess the question I forever have is why? I'm not exactly getting particularly hurt. Like, I don't feel the need to block. If that, you know, makes any sense. Thanks, Momo.
Not all the animals are friendly, particularly the cranky old bears.
Again, there shouldn't be bears. There should be, like, you know, hippo bears or something. Or any of the other ones that were named off when they were in Ba Sing Se. I mean, I know that they haven't gotten, like, that information wouldn't have been released to everybody else, but, like, you know, if you're making a game.
Hello.
Welcome to our village. It's an honor to have the Avatar among us. Tyro said to let you know that they are safe. Thank the spirits, I was concerned. Is everyone accounted for? A young earthbender was kidnapped. Yan was his name. Love how we've forgotten about that immediately. That's terrible. I will send some people to help restore the camp. In the meantime, we'll keep watch around the village. Is there anything else we can do? Perfect timing for an explosion, wouldn't you say? Oh dear, what is that? What was what? Jesus, Aang, are you deaf? I'm not sure, but I fear it may have come from the mine southwest of here. All right, we'll check it out.
The forest is protected.
You know,
if I were the Avatar, I'd have done something about the Fire Nation by now.
Can I talk to you? Can we buy from you? I guess. Yeah, no, most of what you have isn't great. I don't know if I have any leather strips. Silk yin yang paste? That doesn't feel the best. Alright, how do I get out of this? There we go. Isn't that just Haru's dad's voice actor? Forever confusion. Eh, you did meet that guy when you watched it. I was gonna say you don't even know that guy, but nope, you remember Cabbage Dude. He is an Amashu. The city with the crazy earthbender. Yeah. I still don't know why you think this, Aang. They're firebending soldiers. There we go. 4 copper. Still upset that that's not actually the copper that they would use for currency, whatever. It's fine.
Are you warmed up yet?
Come on. There we go. So we go to the mine. There's firebenders on the way to the mine. Am I just gonna have to fight through literal plethora? Hey, Saberwin. We are still playing through the horrendous. We got our 4th Earthbender, but at least it's somebody that's, like, from the show. It's Haru, the guy that never actually taught Aang Earthbending. We skipped over the Earthbender that does teach him. And we're still doing stuff that doesn't at all relate to the show. I'm still shocked how many of the original voice actors they got for this. Yeah, perfect. Oh, good. Okay, so she actually has some real attacks now. I figured out why Sokka's always on fire. It's that enrage. Thanks, Haru. I don't know why you're going to permanently be with our team. This better not be the actual captain from this. Oh. Come on, Captain, say more words. Okay, so do you want to cringe with me for just a second? Because you don't have to witness doing teaching in your house. Oh, no. And I am doing well. I hope things are going better for you. In terms of the cringe, if we're talking the original voice actors, there we go. Okay, so none of that sounds correct. So, how? In Haru's storyline, the Earthbender kid that we just got, the guy chucking rocks. Yeah, yeah, yeah. There we go. In his storyline, the first time we see him and his father are being held captive in an Earthbender, like, prison. They're being used to mine coal. Ah, there we go. At least we got the rhino. The armored rhino. Come on. I want to see what this does. Ah, it's ranged. Okay, and here's why you're going to find this so cringe, Saberwin, though. So Haru and his dad are being held captive by the Fire Nation. Not overly, but you being on my headphones keeps me from hearing the cult ministry. Oh, God. Hey, Edok! Yeah, no, this is not great. In terms of who we have on our team, we have Aang. We have Sokka. Haru. I don't know why we don't have Toph. But we have Haru. And we have Katara. But the story with Haru, when we first meet him, he and his dad are being held captive as prisoners by the Fire Nation. In the show, and this is all in the show, this is not at all how this has happened in the game. But in the show, the captain who is holding Haru and his father hostage is voiced by George Takei. So I was going to be upset if we had Haru with Haru's storyline with all of the original voice cast and they somehow got George Takei to voice this really horrible game.
This way, guys. I'll leave.
Okay, it's going to be yours that we use. There we go. Yeah, this is a rough game. If it wasn't Avatar, I would enjoy this so much. Boomerang wins. Can I not pick that up? Oh, okay, I can.
Okay, let's go.
Drop shot early, but oh. I think I understood all of those words. But yeah, no, this game would be fun if it wasn't Avatar. Like, look at this! We don't have, like, you know, weird other kinds of wolves. We just have... Thanks, Nightbot. We just have regular wolves. I'm not gonna get over that. One sec, let me go again. I appreciate it, because... It's like, I think I understand what all those words mean, but this game is completely rotting my brain. At the time, Takei was probably recording his bit for... part of Lurman in the Clone Wars arc. Yeah, probably. Eh. I know he really enjoyed voicing his character in Avatar The Last Airbender. Because I believe I heard this in a like interview with him. But the entire point of like the Earthbender prison that these guys are being sent to is an internment camp. So he was really appreciative that there was a show that took a lot of Asian influences that bothered to actually talk about internment. So he was more than happy to do his one-off part. Exactly. It's something that's really like close to him personally. So... And especially for how important that this show ended up being in the terms of, like, literally everything. It really showed, like, this was for kids.
If you'd stayed to fight, Uncle might still be here.
Disagree. It's all my brother's fault. Poor Uncle. We were inside the mines when these strange machines suddenly surrounded us. So what'd you do? I ran towards them, but tried to lead them away from my uncle, but my cowardly brother just ran off. Dude has preservation instincts, which you don't. Where's your uncle now? Trapped inside. It's no use. He couldn't have survived the collapsing rock. If he's an earthbender, I doubt that. We should still try.
Goodbye.
Is this it, or is this just my save file? But yeah, this show actually bothered to, like... show real-world consequences for things, like that there's going to be refugees and that there's, you know, good people on the bad guy's side and bad people on the good guy's side. And, like, it showed an actual war with, like, gray areas and all that kind of stuff for kids' programming in the mid-2000s. That's why it's so prolific as it was, that and obviously the art style. Is there the mine somewhere around here? What is this? Why is this here? Do they just reuse certain areas? Oh, I see. You're the only one that can focus move this, Haru. I'm still getting Tarzan vibes every time I hear this music. That is not Haru's voice actor. I think that is the only voice actor they didn't get, because he knew. What is... Oh. Alright, that's gotta be Haru. Having met the man twice, I know how close he is to his Japanese heritage and things that reflect that and stay close to his heart. I never met him, but I did... I had, like, pre-ordered his graphic novel about his life growing up in the internment camps. So, I'm familiar with it, and I actually ended up reading through the book with a kid I was tutoring as well.
Are you warmed up yet?
Ah, come on. Your guys' hitboxes are so weird. And I can't, like, audio balance this game well. There we go. Can I? Options. Sound options.
All in a day's.
We're just going to turn down the sound effects a little more, and we're just going to hope for the best with that. Okay, resume is start menu. I don't know what direction I'm supposed to be going and which direction I'm not supposed to be going, but I'm going to go the other direction before I leave. Ow! I don't like that I can't combo these things. That's fine. Just kill it. There we go. Hard to tell what all actually hits on these things. Ah, no.
Are you warmed up yet?
It's robots. I'm blocking, in case anyone can't tell. Akon's, when he does his panels, he talks about his past as well as his biggest roles. Well, I mean, I wouldn't expect anything less from him as an activist, either. I still have to make it hard to breathe. Oh, well, then that would be you. Too fast, huh? So they don't penalize you for too late, but they do for too fast. Thanks. Now we got more of these things. I like that there's just crystals. Ow. Can I just knock these things into oblivion? Please? Yeah, I would love to get my hands on a copy of, like, his musical, but you have to pay, like, 6 arms and 2 legs to be able to afford the one copy that they were releasing to people. And I was like, well, I guess I'm not gonna...
Stay down.
And I remember talking about this with my... with my one friend. Ah! Woo! Move. And I started saying, like, oh, yeah, I would 100%... like, just listen to the soundtrack. But I have, like, a rule about that. And my friend goes, oh, is it that you only listen to the soundtracks of musicals that you were in? And I was like,
problem solved.
What? No, who does that?
Hey, let's go.
They're like, yeah, no, I knew somebody in school who was like that. And I was like, that's just so pretentious. I'm like, no, I have a rule that I only will listen to the soundtracks of musicals that are considered operas, because the difference between a musical and an opera is in opera, less than 20% of the, like, production is spoken word. And, you know, in musicals, it's more than 20%. So if you listen to just a musical, you might be missing a lot of the story and the details and the narrative. But if you listen to an opera, you get, like, 90% of the story. Well, I guess statistically you get, you know, 80% of the story. So I was like, I have a rule where I only listen, like, if I'm going to, like, listen to things, I'd rather listen to the opera if I'm going to listen to the whole soundtrack, because then I get the whole picture and the whole context for it, rather than if I just listen to it as a musical form. My friend goes, well, that makes sense. I go, see, thank you. Yes, that. I'm like, it's not some pretentious reason. It's literally because I don't want to miss context of this musical or opera that I'm watching. So technically, by the way, Sweeney Todd is an opera. Hamilton is considered a rap opera. Yep. Yeah. I was just saying that as that. But yeah, Sweeney Todd is considered an opera. I was in Sweeney Todd, of all things. I don't think... I can't remember if Les Mis is or is not, but, like, 90% of Sondheim is, like, opera. Hamilton's an opera, less than 20% of it is spoken word. It's considered a rap opera. Just to let your brain wrap around that concept for a second. A rap opera.
Hey,
Which almost feels like that would be counterintuitive, but it's not. It just doesn't have, like, it's... Like, the... Ooh. Yeah, no kidding. When people think of opera, they think of, like, the standard Italian operatic where you can kind of sometimes understand the words. I don't even know if I'm still going the right way. I'm just still going through this mine.
Are we ready?
I'm glad Katara gets to do some stuff finally.
I have to teach you that, Aang.
I might just play as Katara for a bit for like literally no other reason than because I want to. Ooh, fall back. Alright, we're just gonna... Ah, come on. Switch back. I was wondering because... I know when Burton adapted, so many walked out because it's a musical. Okay, I'm actually upset. I know this is gonna seem weird, but I'm upset about the Tim Burton version only because he cut out so many of the musical elements. There was so much of it that was actually, like, no kidding, they had entire choruses that were singing it. But, you know, I kind of grew up in a world that, like, as a conscious adult that would, not adult, but like a conscious person that would choose to go see it. Or, like, you know, read it on DVD or something like, read it on DVD. Watch it on DVD or something like that. I was, like, adult enough. Thank you. That I was adult enough to, like, know. Like, the concepts, we went into it knowing what to expect. Ooh. Come on. I guess we'll just walk this way and we'll let them come to us. Although, I will say one of my favorite, it's a musical moments. Came when my dad and I went to go see Into the Woods, and I spent the entire car ride telling him, like, hey, just so you're aware, this is in fact a musical. Like, there's gonna be moments where we break into song. And my dad's just going, yeah, okay, whatever, in the car. And like, no kidding, 2 minutes into the movie, singing starts. My dad turns to me and goes, hey, is this a musical? Yes, Dad, that is what I spent the last 10 minutes in the car telling you. It was great. Look, I'm hoping that when I play the rest of the Avatar games, because I will at some point, that they will be more cohesive to the main story than whatever this is. I think one of the other ones is better. Oh, thanks. Katara's voiced by the female X, by the way, in Scott Pilgrim, in case anyone was curious. What is... It's just lanterns? I can't interact with them? I know there is an overture. They look out, attend the tale of Sweeney Todd. His main motif was supposed to be swing your razor high, Sweeney. Yep. Especially because of like how high-pitched, by the way, that motif is. When you sing it, it's purposely almost off-key a little bit as a result. I still have like my lyrics for that whole thing. Oof. It was a fun musical to be in, though. Most of the cast almost died. Which said something when we're a bunch of high schoolers, by the way. There we go. Come on, just... What's for Grand-Grand? Grand-Grand's alive, well, and doing fine. In the Southern Water Tribe. I want to know if any of the voice actors looked at these lines and was like, that is not something Sokka would ever say, or that's not something Aang would ever... Like, just the thought. Thanks for dying so late. Sweeney, I was working at the Cineplex and laughed so hard when people were mad. Musical, like, didn't you catch the trailer? No. If anything, and I know that this is a later comparison, but Deadpool. Like, the entirety of the Deadpool movie tells me that parents just don't, like, in general, that people just don't pay attention. Ow. To, like, what's in trailers or what goes on. Because the number of parents who were outraged at Deadpool for not being children-friendly and a superhero movie after they had already had their kid in the theater.
You can't do that with airbending.
Dude, Katara.
Let's go.
I don't even know if I'm going the right direction. I should probably queue up the other quest. I don't know if I did. There's a vid I have on my phone, which is a music theory of how loaded Sweeney is. I mean, he was, like, he got away with a lot. Oh. Thank you for the movement. Yeah, this is like literally slowing down my whole team, and that's half the problem. Guess just keep hitting them. Come on. There we go. Yeah, save it here, please. I do not understand how some of the save functions work. Toon was everywhere in that production. I mean, it was. It really was. And that was... The reason that toon was there is that toon was supposed to represent the chorus that was supposed to be singing. And it wasn't so much that it was the chorus, like, that it was them repeating that toon for being, like, artistically accurate or, you know, making it like his theme song or whatever. Sondheim already did that. He already made it the theme song for Sweeney. If you notice in Sweeney Todd, and literally just anything else that Sondheim does, that he like has... It's not just him. It's like all musicals in general. But there's usually like a melody for each character. Right? You hear it best in Notre Dame, like the Notre Dame musical, is when you'll hear it like the best. Where is the Turn Lost Toys? Oh my god. Well, let's just find the brother first. So, what you end up hearing, though, as that result, is you're hearing the chorus and not directly Sweeney. And they only did it in sections that had the choruses, like, that the chorus would take over and sing, like, a whole, this is who this guy is kind of thing. Anything else around here? No. That dude seemed so unconcerned. Like, hey, we're here to save you. We all thought you died in this cave-in. Hi. Like, dude. Oh, jeez. All right. Help. Please help me. And that's so out of character, even with, like, the rest of what he's saying. We need to get out of here. Okay, just follow me. I would, but my leg, it's injured and I can't walk. Katara might be able to help with this. You're just gonna heal him outright? Heal the uncle.
Let's go.
Heal. Oh, that was... Oh. Oh. I'm gonna have to backtrack. I see.
See you.
Piece of cake.
Great, we healed him.
Hello.
Dude. seriously, just be like lightly a bit more concerned. Thank you. My leg feels so much better. It's truly a great gift you have. You're welcome. Let's get out of here. The mine is still very unstable. Follow us.
Bye.
Dude, this guy literally just mailed it in. I swear to you. It was like probably some developer that they had just like hanging out in the back. Right? That was just like, hi. Hey. Help. You know, like some guy who hasn't slept in 3 days straight. So I had a brain fart and apparently sent the video twice. The deep dive. I still have to watch that. I've been like, things have been weird going on. I think part of the problem is like, I've been having more medical problems. Not that I'm going to like go into them, but it's just like, it's particularly flaring up in not the best way. Ah, that does answer some questions. Okay, well, I guess I'm just used to how Aang controls, so we're just gonna stick with that. Something Jill Sandwich just sent the Sweeney vid. I have to say, it was really, I had to do like an in-depth study on Sweeney Todd back when I was like in it. It was a whole thing. I mean, obviously you want to make sure that you're doing your part right, but like, boy, I'm never going to forget some of the whole, like, because our teacher would try to like have us analyze it first before we'd go into a scene, so that this way we would go into it like level-headed. We did the same thing for, oh, here you go. Dude, your bravery and courage are to be commended. Thank you. Maybe these two stopped arguing all the time. They'd see that actions speak louder than words. They are troubled boys. Why? My brother, their father, was taken and jailed by the corrupt soldiers of the dark iron he carried. Oh, I knew I recognized you. We freed your brother. My brother is free from prison? That's wonderful news. Did you hear that, boys? Thank you so much. You're welcome. I don't remember that we... Okay. We are truly fortunate to have met you today. Please, take this with our deepest thanks. Take care, won't you? Thanks. Goodbye.
Maybe if you two stopped arguing all the...
Oh, see, where was that voice line before? But yeah, one of the ones I'll never forget is when we were prepping for Les Mis. And, like, they're talking about, like, the look down at the very beginning, like, the very first song.
Time, you'd see that action speaks louder than words.
Let's see, it's so much better than hey. All right. Sorry. But, you know, teachers, like, you know, so why are we looking down? People are like, because they're afraid to face God and, like, all these metaphorical reasons. And I'm literally, like, they don't want to get the snot kicked out of them by the prison guards. And the teacher goes, thank you, that. And I'm just like, this is so funny because all of these people are, like, given these, like, great philosophical responses. He goes, yes, these are the philosophical answers to, like, what we're talking about. That is great. Don't overlook that. But I didn't need to hit all those at once. It's fine. Oh, well, there we go. I'm breaking the rhino.
I won't let you escape.
Thank you. Hey. Not that I use that at all anyway. Thank you. Wow, Sokka. All right.
I don't have enough energy. Stand strong.
Did they purposely make Sokka run out of energy with that? All right.
I don't have enough energy.
But I don't know. There was a part of me that just kind of cracked up a little bit over that.
I'm too drained.
Oh, Sokka. This guy's probably blocking. Sokka, you're not out. Stop. The guy who does the vid I sent does an in-depth music theory where he breaks down the scores and stuff in his vids. Ooh, that is cool. Please, just beat them. Sokka, I believe in you. Come on, Sokka. You little glass cannon, you. I think I understand now why the hitboxes on this are weird. It's hard to tell when stuff is, like, blocking or not blocking unless you're, like, fighting a person.